What's going on, you guys? My name is Woof, and welcome to today's video. So in today's video, I'm going to tell you guys 5 money mistakes that college students can make. Number one, not creating a budget. Budgets are extremely important in college. Sometimes you only have a set amount of money that you can spend. Sometimes you have a set amount of money that your parents will give you for college every month or every week. Creating a budget is very important, so you know how much you need to spend on food, other expenses, and have like a fund where you have an emergency expense, like if you get sick or something happens, so an emergency budget just in case something happens. But you want to create a budget in college so you know how much money you have and how much money you can spend, how much money you want to save. Even in college, even if you're living at home or in an apartment, you want to be able to save amount of money for a rainy day, for an emergency, for something big like a new house or a new car or a used car just with less miles on it, or an emergency like doggo needs her teeth cleaned, I need to do that. So you want to have like money saved for that, but you want to have a budget so you can save that money, know what you need to spend, know how much food you need and what part of your budget will go into that, what fun things you can do with your budget money that you have left, and anything else you may want. So creating a budget is very important because you do have a limited amount of money in college. Even if you have a part-time job, your money is limited, so you want to have a good budget and a good net just in case something were to happen, and a good budget for something like books. Number two, not using credit cards correctly or using credit cards incorrectly. Credit cards are not free money. The providers are not giving you free money. So if you rack up so much credit card debt, you will end up with more debt compared to if you were just having college debt, so you'd have credit card and college debt. So you would be in basically a hole. But credit cards are not free money. So you have to make payments on your credit card. You can't just rack up so much money and expect for it to go away, or expect you not to have something that you have to pay off in the future. So you have to use your credit cards very wisely and very sparingly, especially if you have a limited amount of income or no income at all. If you have no income at all, then a credit card might not be best for you, but if you have maybe a little bit of income that you can pay off on your credit card, it might work. But don't use your credit cards incorrectly, because it'll end you in a hole deeper than just college debt. Number three, not finishing classes. Classes cost money. You paid for those classes, your financial aid paid for those classes, and if you don't finish these classes, you're gonna have that money gone anyways, but you'll have 3 less credit hours that you could have had if you finished it. So that just means that money is gone and you have to pay it back anyways, even though you didn't finish that class. And there's a good chance you'll have to take that class over, so that's just more money towards the same class. So not finishing your classes just means you spend more money, and another money mistake, because if you don't finish that, then you still have to pay that class off because you still took that class, you paid for it. It's too late to get a refund, so that class still has to be paid for. Number four, not applying to financial aid and scholarships. Financial aid does have to be paid back. Depending on what kind of financial aid you get, like a Parent Plus or unsubsidized or subsidized, depends on when you pay it back. Some college students do use that money towards an apartment, a house, a car, or just to survive on for that semester. So applying to financial aid and scholarships definitely does help, especially if you're on a limited budget. Of course, you do have to pay back that financial aid, but for scholarships, you don't have to pay that back. You get that money, and you don't have to pay it back to any financial aid. You can use that money to pay off your car, buy food, pay off an apartment, or pay off more financial aid that you might have gotten. So take advantage of that and apply for scholarships and financial aid whenever you can, because it can help you in the long run, and that is money that you get that you can use towards anything that you need to, including classes. Number five, spending too much money on food. Food expires, so when it expires, all that money you spent towards that expired food goes down the drain, because you can't eat that food anymore if it's expired. Some food, like canned food, maybe, but stuff like milk, eggs, stuff that really goes bad, you can't eat that. So all that food that you spent money on goes down the drain, your money's gone, and you have to go buy more food. So don't waste your money on too much food that you know you're not going to eat and that you're just going to have sitting there for who knows how long, because that money will end up being wasted if you don't eat it and that food gets expired or gets gross and just goes down the drain or gets trashed. So create a budget on what you're going to eat or what you're going to make for dinner or what you're going to have for dinner. Using that budget, you can find out how much food you're going to eat, what food you're going to eat, or what food you're going to need, instead of just spending a lot of money on a bunch of food that you don't really know you're going to eat, and you just want to have it, but food expires, so you just have to be careful with how much food you buy and how much money you spend on food. It is important to have food, but so much of it can end up being a negative thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and end this video. So thank you guys so much for watching this video. And as usual, you guys, I'll see you guys next time in the next video. So see you guys later.